Thank you. a call and be like, hey, it's so good to talk to a pure blooded Australian.
Yeah.
And I'm like, ooh! Look at this dude! Get up here, think I'm all Australian.
Why that's not like a video call?
Yeah. Bro, you'd think I'm a fucking terrorist. Especially with that beard. You would not trust my backpack.
You would not trust my backpack.
Received an actual bill, it was fucking high shit. 1800.
Compared to his bills that were estimated, and they were all like 150. I'm like,
150 is not bad though. Like, how many people live in his property?
He was quarterly for some reason. He was getting his electricity bills for 90 days. I don't know why. All of them were 90 days. He was getting quarterly invoices.
That's
not normal. No. I didn't play that with anyone because I was like, I
just
wanted to.
I was trying to stop talking to this crap.
Yeah. Well, he called it.
Well, if he says that, he's like, look, I can't talk with you
anymore. Yeah. He called yesterday, and I spoke to him for like, and then he called today, and the company was the same thing. And then he comes up, I saw his name, and I was like, that's what I was like, because I'm like, what? I saw his name and I was like,
first fuck ride.
Joined up with Eli 3 months ago, maybe? companies there to include diversity advisor. And the reason that I know her is when I joined RPV, I was like, wow, there's nothing here around inclusivity or diversity. And I reached out to the RPV mailbox and got like nothing. And then I chased it up a few times, and then poor old Pip must have just started and had all these like emails from me being
then maybe
like,
I'll be like, this is a problem.
She was like, hey, so nice to hear from you, and we had a coffee, and then I've just had her a few times, so she's really lovely.
That's her actual name, Pip?
Yeah. That's actual name. I know quite a few Australians called Pip. British people as well. It's often short for Philip.
Okay.
But I think in her case it's just people. Yeah, I know a few people who are short. I quite like Pip as a name. Maybe it is Australian.
So it's nothing.
Yeah. It's funny, the names coming back into fashion. Like, a lot of old names coming back in, I've noticed. Friends naming their kids, like, Frank. But yeah, anyway, that's why. And we were going to have a drink a few weeks ago, and then she got stuck at work, and we'd organised this ages ago. And I was like,
what?
Oh, have you been to Farmer's Daughters before?
No, it's on my list. It's been on my list for a while.
It's a cool little rooftop. My mate manages it. Who may or may not be there.
Megan special treatment.
After last time, God, I gave them an absolute serve after that. I was like, your staff is so shit. He stayed in my house for a couple of weeks too. I was like, you better send me a few vouchers for that crappy restaurant.
I mean, Derek is
The rooftop's really nice. So it's like it's three levels.
Yeah.
So the bottom is like a bistro, which is if you ever go to eat there, it's on the bottom level.
Mm-hmm.
It's like nice, like not too pretentious. And then the middle level is like really fancy. It's just like really like, you know.
I guess that's why that they kind of give you half a bit.
Yeah. You get 14 plates and you leave hungry, that kind of vibe probably.
I mean, it's kind of.
But the chef, the exec chef, is a guy called Alejandro. I can't pronounce his surname anyway, it's Peruvian.
I know who you're talking about. People might talk.
So I worked with him very briefly, and with Scott, who's the manager at St. Elmo. And the chef had come from Sydney, and he got involved with the group when they opened Pastruso. So Pastruso was his first place, and then they had a big fight, and he left the business and opened and he's actually really
festivals.
But his philosophy is actually
it's very slavish. all your weekends you're working.
Well, yeah, I mean, you wouldn't, like, when you're at that, like, managing, you don't have to do weekends, but it's just the, like, surf. I just don't think I can surf with you anymore. I get too frustrated, too annoyed with people.
You're drinking,
yeah, I'm like, don't speak to me like that. But you meant to be like, customer's always right. And I think since COVID, it's all worse.
Really?
People are more precious, and staff don't want to work as much, so it's always a struggle. Like, they're all in these venues, trying to keep staff at the moment, because people keep, like, I guess, I guess people have had, like, a real change in perspective. Yeah.
side of the tram.